In this video, I want to show you the interactive control reference of DCS BIOS. You probably already know the control reference, and it's two display modes, simple and advanced. However, if you install the control reference as a Google Chrome extension, you get access to a new mode in which you can view live data from your cockpit and manipulate its controls for testing. In Google Chrome, open the menu, click Settings, and click Extensions. Check the Developer Mode checkbox at the top and click the Load Unpacked Extension button. Then select the folder where the DCS BIOS reference documentation has been copied to. In my case, it's on my D drive, data, DCS BIOS, script, DCS BIOS, doc. Select the doc folder and click OK. You will see that a new extension has been installed, which you can launch using this link, or if you have it enabled, using the apps button in your bookmarks bar. I have already got DCS running in the background, so when I start this up, it will try to connect. If it has worked, you will see this arrow here rotating. That's just an update counter that increases every time DCS BIOS sends an update. If this is not rotating, start DCS first and then press F5 to refresh the page. Now I can switch to the latency, and whenever you open a new panel here, it will take a while to synchronize, approximately up to 10 seconds. So for example, I can now go to another panel here. As you see, after a few seconds, the values show up. You can also use the interactive reference documentation to manipulate switches in your cockpit. If I switch to the CMSP here and wait for the synchronization, I see it's the display is empty now. And let's switch our countermeasures panel on. So go to CMSP mode select and press the increase button. As you can see, it moves the switch in the cockpit. Whenever you click a button in the reference documentation, the label on the button is the command that gets sent to DCS. If you have a set state interface like this, you use the slider to select the button label, then click the button to send the command to DCS. So because this button shows 2 right now, it will set my CMSP mode dial to position 2, no matter where it was before. And of course, I can use the same way to turn it back off. Also, when this is switched on, and I scroll back up to this display, I can watch the values change when the display changes in the cockpit. This method is a good way to get an idea of what values to expect, how long the strings will be, and what the various commands that you can send to DCS will actually do.